मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स लर्न टुडे एक्सरसाइज 8.3 क्वेश्चन नंबर 5। आई बाय अ टीवी फॉर रुपीज 10,000। आई बाय अ टीवी फॉर रुपीज 10,000 एंड सेल इट। आई हैव सेल इट एट अ प्रॉफिट ऑफ 20%। ओके, सो हाउ मच मनी डू आई गेट फॉर इट। See now what is given, that I will write here first. I buy a TV and I sell it. So I buy. Okay. So what is the cost price? Rupees 10,000. I buy a TV for 10,000 rupees. Okay. So cost price, how much it is? Rupees 10,000. Okay. And after that what it is given? And sell it. I sell TV. At a profit of 20%. So what I will write here? Sell it at a profit of 20%. Means I sell the TV at a profit of 20%. So how much money do I get for it? See, cost price is given. I sell it for at a profit of 20%. How much money do I get for it? Means I should know the selling price. Means I sell it for 20% profit. So what is my selling price? That I have to find. I sell it at a profit of 20%. I sell the TV at a profit of 20%. So what is my selling price? At what price I have sold the TV? Okay, so here I have to find the selling price is equal to how much. Okay, so selling price I have to find. But for that, see, selling price is equal to cost price plus profit. Selling price is equal to cost price plus profit. See, I need to find selling price. See, here I will show. Selling price is equal to cost price plus profit. Now you will say, madam, we need to recite these formulas. No need to recite this formula. You know the formula for profit. Profit is equal to selling price minus cost price. So as per that, we have to use the transversal rule and we can make our own formulas using this formula. Okay. So see here, selling price is equal to cost price plus profit. Now cost price we know. But profit we know, we don't know the profit. We know the profit percent. Okay, we know the profit, we don't know the profit. We know the profit percent. At a profit of 20%. So, selling price we have to find. So, cost price we know. Cost price is 10,000. But profit we have to find. Okay, so for that what we will do? See here, I will draw this. Afterwards we will do this. Okay, so I need to find the selling price. So for that what it is given? Profit of 20%. So we need to find the profit. So profit is equal to. So profit is equal to. Profit is equal to 20% of 10,000. Why 20% of 10,000? Why 20% of 10,000? See, it is given. I bought a TV for rupees 10,000 and I sell it at a profit of 20%. So we need to find the profit, and I sell it at a profit of 20%. Okay, so all this 20% we have to find. This is cost price. Okay, this is cost price. 10,000 is cost price, and on that 20% profit, on this cost price 20% profit, it is given. Sell it at a profit of 20%. I sell it at profit of 20%. So 20% means how much? So 20% of 10,000 we have to find. So we will get the profit. Okay, so we will get the how much profit. For how much profit we have sold, we know at 20% profit I have sold, but don't know the amount, so that we have to find. So on which we will find? On 10,000. So 20% is 20 upon 100 of means multiplication. 10,000. Okay, 20% of 10,000. Okay, 20% of 10,000. Now this upper zero, downside zero get cancelled. Now this upper zero, this downside zero get cancelled. So what will remain? 2 into 1000. Okay, so what we got here? Rupees 2000 we got profit. Rupees 2000 we got profit. Profit how much we got? Rupees 2000. So profit we got. Now what I said, we need to find the selling price. So what I say, what is the formula for selling price? Selling price is equal to cost price plus profit. Selling price is equal to cost price plus profit. See, you know the formula for profit. See, if you don't know what is the formula now to find the selling price. See, you know the formula for profit. Profit is equal to selling price minus cost price. This you know. This you know. Profit is equal to selling price minus cost price. Okay, this you know. Now what you need to find? Selling price. Na? Selling price you will need to find. So if you will transfer this cost price to left hand side. See, so it is minus CP. So if it will come to this side, then it is plus cost price. Okay, so selling price formula you got profit plus cost price. Cost price plus profit. Understood how to form the formula? One, if we know only formula for profit, we can create the formulas for others also. Okay, no need to recite each and every formula. By using transversal rule, we can create the formula. Okay, so selling price is equal to cost price plus profit. So what is the cost price? Cost price is 10,000 rupees. Rupees 10,000. And what is the profit? Profit we got 2,000 rupees. Okay. So profit we got 2,000 rupees. So now add this 10,000 plus 2,000. 12,000. So what we got? Selling price rupees 12,000. And what it is asked? How much money do I get for it? So how much money I will get? Rupees 12,000. For question number 6. Zuhi sells a washing machine for rupees 13,500. She sells a washing machine for rupees 13,500. So what is the selling price? Selling price is equal to 13,500 rupees. Okay, it is given. Okay, she loses of 20% in the bargain. You know what is mean by bargain? Suppose if I will go in the market to purchase one t-shirt, the shopkeeper will say the cost of t-shirt is 500 rupees, but I will say him to give it for the 400 rupees. So that is called the bargain. Okay. So the same way here, she loses 20% in the bargain. 20% in the bargain. So what it is given? Loss percent is given. So what it is given? Loss percent. How much it is? Loss percent 20%. Okay, loss percent how much it is? 20. How much loss it is? 20%. Loss percent is 20. Okay, now what it is given? What was the price at which she bought it? Means at what price she bought? Okay, she sold it for 13,500 rupees. Okay, and she loses of 20%. She loses 20%, means loss percent is given. So at what price she bought? Means we have to find here cost price. What we have to find? Cost price. Cost price is equal to how much? Okay, so we need to find here cost price. Okay. And what is given? She loses. So loss, she has got loss in this transaction. Okay, so loss is equal to, okay, loss we have to calculate on CP. Okay, so 20% of cost price. Okay, always it's calculated on CP. Okay, how much loss she has got, that we have to find now. It is given in percent, but how much percent? So loss is equal to 20% of CP. Okay, so CP means cost price. Now cost price we don't know, so let cost 20% is 20 upon 100 of means multiplication and CP. CP now what we consider cost price is equal to X. So X. Okay. So now upper 0, downside 0 get cancelled. Then 2 1s are 2, 2 5s are 10. So 1 upon 5 multiplied by X. Now 1 into X, X, X upon 5. So what we got? Loss we got X upon 5. Here loss we got X upon 5. Loss we got X upon 5. See, it is given loss percent here. And loss what we got? X upon 5. And what we have to find? CP. What we have to find? CP. Okay. So CP. CP we have to find. So CP is equal to SP plus loss. SP plus loss. CP is equal to SP plus loss. See, cost price is equal to selling price plus loss. Now you will say, madam, how this formula you got? See, loss, you know, loss formula, you know, loss. Loss formula, you know, loss formula. What is the formula for loss? Cost price minus selling price. Cost price minus selling price. Okay, loss is equal to cost price minus selling price. Okay, and what we have to find? We have to find the CP, na? CP, cost price is here. If we will transfer selling price to this cell, then it will be add. See, selling price is here minus. If we will transfer to left hand side, then it will become plus. So what will come? Loss plus SP is equal to CP. So again you got the formula for CP. CP is equal to loss plus SP. CP is equal to loss plus SP. Or CP is equal to SP plus loss. SP plus loss. So it is up to you. If you want to reset the formula, you can reset. But if you know the only formula for profit, loss, profit percent and loss percent, then you can create remaining all the formulas. Okay. Then you can create your remaining all the formulas. No need to reset all the formulas. Okay. Now CP. CP, let cost price be X. CP we consider X. So write here X. We have considered cost price is X. Now selling price. Selling price is given 13,500. Selling price is given 13,500. And what is loss? Loss we got X upon 5. Loss we got X upon 5. Now see here, students, see here, everyone, it is loss. Don't write here 20%. It is loss percent is given 20%. Loss what we got? X upon 5. Okay, now this X upon 5, if we will transfer to this side, then it will become minus. See, it is here plus X upon 5. If we will transfer to left hand side, then it will become minus. So X minus X upon 5. This X as it is. Okay. And this X upon 5. It is here plus. If we will transfer to this side, then it will become minus. Okay. Is equal to 13,500. Okay. Remain 13,500 as it is. Okay. Now see. Here there is no denominator means 1. Let's make the denominator equal. So now, here if you will multiply by 5 for denominator, you have to multiply by 5 for the numerator. We have to make the denominator equal, na? So what is the LCM in this? LCM is 5. So if you will multiply by 5 for the denominator, you have to multiply by 5 for the numerator. So what it will come? 5x upon 5. Okay. Minus X upon 5. Okay, X upon 5, why here no need to multiply by 5? Because already denominator is here. 5 is equal to 13,500 as it is. Okay, now 5X minus X. 5X minus X means 1X. 5X minus 1X means 4X. So 4X upon 5 is equal to 13,500. Okay. Now see, this 5, if you will transfer to right hand side, then it will become multiplied. See, 5 is here, divide. If you will transfer to right hand side, then it will become multiplied. So, 4x will remain here. Transfer this 5 to the right hand side. So, 13,500 multiplied by 5. See, 4x upon 5. This 5 I transfer to the right hand side. Then it will become multiplied. Okay. So now, this 4 is here multiplied. If we will transfer to right hand side, then it will become divide. So x is equal to 13,500 multiplied by 5 upon 4. Why 4? We have divided because it is here multiplied. If we will transfer to right hand side, then it will become divide. Okay, so x is equal to, now divide this first. See, 4 ones are 4, 4 threes are 12. Okay, 4 threes are 12, 1 will remain here. Again, 4 threes are 12. Okay, so what will remain here? 3. 4 sevens are 28, and 4 fives are 20. So 3375 will get. See, if you do not understand this way, you can divide in row. 13,500 divided by 4. See, let's check. 4 threes are 12. Okay, 3 minus 2, 1. 1 minus 1, 0. 5 will come down. Okay, 4 threes are 12. 5 minus 2, 3. 1 minus 1, 0. Now, 0 will come down. 4 sevens are 28. Okay, 4 sevens are 28. Now, 30 minus 28 remain 2. Or you can do the borrow. Take the borrow 10 minus 8, 2. Here will remain 2. 2 minus 2, 0. Now 0 will come down. 4 5s are 20. So what we got here? 3375. Okay. So we got here 3375. So 3375 multiplied by 5. Okay. So do this multiplication. See, 3375 multiplied by 5. Okay. So 5 5s are 25. Okay, 5 sevens are 35, 35 plus 2, 37. Okay, 3 is carried, 5 threes are 15, 15 plus 3, 18, 1 is carried, 5 threes are 15 and 1, 16. Okay, so what we got? 16,875. Okay. So, x is equal to 16,875. X means what? Cost price. Okay. X means what? See, let cost price be x. We consider cost price as x. We consider cost price x. So, we got cost price 16,875. Okay. So, what we will write after that? What was the price at which she bought it? So, she bought it for rupees 16,875.